This is where I get off, runt.
Where are you running off to all of a sudden?
Found me that slimy hut I was talking about. He's been getting fat and happy all these years after crossing me. Time he gets what's coming to him.
If you get caught, you're on your own.
Huh? Like I need a hand from a wimp like you. Try not getting killed. Gonna want something to do when I get back.
You're back.
Ain't like a bunch of hut flunkies was gonna give me trouble. Would have been back sooner, but the slug and I had a lot of catching up to do.
I assume this grudge of yours is finished?
Only thing left for that hut is getting hosed off the walls.
Made contact with some of my cousins. It's strange, but a start.
They receptive to a meeting?
I think so. Eventually. Got a lot to learn before I try leading a clan. Fighting alongside Mandalore's Chosen can't hurt.
What's so special about this little gadget anyway? It's obviously something you put a lot of care into.
You're not gonna believe this. I heard from Hilo. She's willing to take me back if I'm willing to show she means more to me than me. Sent the message certified, credits on delivery. Oof, almost cleaned me out just to have it delivered.
I hope you get her back. She's my kind of lady.
One of a kind. Too bad it took me this long to figure it out. I feel like I'm back in my prime. Not that I'd slipped, I'm just unburdened. I owe you for that, so I thought I'd say it. Don't go making a big deal out of it.
Never.
I've got to hand it to you. You really surprised me. You're not what I would call a conventional partner in crime. But we're really turning out to make quite the team.
Letting you live was one of my better decisions.
I do think it's because we got all of that pesky trying to kill each other out of the way early. You and me, we're going to carve out a criminal empire, or at least accumulate one heck of a fortune. Your children's children won't know what to do with it. I'm telling you, wild space is the limit.
Hey, I was scanning the holonet and just lost track of time. Where is everybody? It's so quiet. I thought for a second I'd gotten on the wrong ship.
We got plenty of work to do. They should be busy.
Then let's not waste our chance to be alone. Okay, admit it. You pitched the guys out an airlock. It's okay, I won't judge. This time, anyway. You know what? You're okay.
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
Sort of egotistical, but still, okay. When Brayden first talked about you, I don't know what I expected, but whatever it was, you're better. What I want to say is, you're awesome, and if you were lost in the same sector, I would definitely give you directions.
And if someone put a bounty on your head, I'd shoot him for you.
You wouldn't collect on it first? That's really sweet of you. All right, anyway, you get the point. Let's get back to work.
The Jedi are broken. The Republic forces are in disarray. Now is the time to strike. You will depart Corellia. Make for the Founder, the Supreme Chancellor's flagship, immediately. The Founder's landing codes will give the Republic fleet little reason to fire upon you.
Were the landing codes the only thing of worth?
Only the most relevant. The data retrieved from June Seros has proven invaluable. Captain Horn has prepared an SOS signal using the Republic's ciphers. When you leave the spaceport, you will be pursued by our ships. The Republic will allow you to board, or they risk allowing one of their own to die. We will give them no time for doubt.
Will your pilots know I'm on their side?
Their orders will be to stop you at all costs. I expect you can handle it. You will reach the Founder by any means necessary. Once on board, your first priority will be to destroy all crafts in the adjacent hangars to prevent the Supreme Chancellor from escaping.
Improvised demolition is one of my specialties.
With no means of escape, only the Supreme Guard will stand between you and your prey.
I'm ready to depart for the Founder at any time.
I will await you on the Tyrant. The Supreme Chancellor's fate is sealed.
Next time.
So many people willing to lay down their lives for me. Should never have come to this. There's something I want to tell you, before you do what you came to do.
It's not every day I get to chat with the leader of the Free Galaxy.
I'd ask you to sit, but I prefer not to kid myself. I reviewed the reports surrounding the operation to apprehend you. It's atrocious. A monumental abuse of power. I don't condone what you were doing, but I understand it. It was just your job. June made it personal.
It would have come to this eventually. You're good business.
Maybe before, but now I wouldn't be so sure. I've declassified the details of June Seros' actions against you. Soon the Senate and the people will know that elements of my administration doctored official records to further a personal agenda. The fallout will be tremendous. No matter how our meeting concludes, I'll be removed from office.
I'm sure it wasn't easy to come clean, knowing your career would be sunk.
June had no right to deceive the public, and neither do I. The people must be able to believe their leaders. The false accusations will disappear as the truth is separated from the lies. It's not a clean slate, but it's what you deserve. I'm willing to take things a step further, if you're willing to work with me.
Give me a reason to believe anything you've said.
The reports are right here. Take a look for yourself. Keep them. Whatever will allay your suspicion. My offer is immunity for your past crimes. The real ones. If you're willing to show me you're not firmly in the Empire's pocket. June believed you were in league with a Sith named Tormund. Is that true?
We have a partnership of convenience, that's all.
It's a partnership you should end. Tormund's a monster. His troops have been butchering Corellians. On Raban, he flattened kilometers of homes, businesses, hospitals. A man like that can't be given more power. Let's fix this while we're in a position to do so.
I'm glad you cleared that up for us. I'd have never suspected a Lord of the Sith to be so cruel. Come on, you've seen what that mechanized terror is capable of. Let's stay on what passes for his good side.
That monster's had me under his thumb long enough.
Yeah, you're gonna be under his boot if you're not careful.
Keep your word and Tormund will disappear.
I understand the risk you're taking. Thank you.
The Supreme Chancellor's been dealt with.
Good. Make for the Tyrant. The fleet will cover your escape.
We'll engage the Imperial fleet, but I'll have to survive this to hold up my end of the bargain. If you can somehow cripple the Tyrant after dealing with Tormund, we can handle the rest.
The Tyrant won't trouble you, Chancellor.
Vengeance and satisfaction. The Supreme Chancellor's death has excited your passions. Relish it. Experience some small measure of what it is to be Sith. Now, deliver what I have asked of you.
I'm afraid you'll have to accept a substitution.
I expected better. Deserved.
Rule with a clenched fist? You better be prepared to scrap.
Trusting in a tool, however useful, was a mistake. The task of delivering the masterstroke I should have reserved for myself. The galaxy would know. None are beyond my reach. All would cower, or they would burn. And the Dark Council would see how total victory is achieved.
Even Sith don't get everything they want.
Hoping to find you alive. Quite a narrow escape. Darth Tormund was not as fortunate, I trust.
I took care of him personally.
Good. At least it's done. Perhaps it's best that I'm getting out of politics. Ranging assassinations couldn't be farther from what I've stood for. After falling this far, I suppose there's no point in trying to recover my principles. Coming clean would only do more harm than good.
You don't cast off honor when it's inconvenient.
I never said I was excusing my failures. Only living with them. It was for a greater good. We may be far from achieving peaceful coexistence, but the fewer men like Tormund that come to power, the better our chances. As far as anyone knows, Tormund died in a foolish naval battle. Let's leave it that way.
You're a good man, Chancellor. The Republic will be worse off without you.
I'm glad you weren't the monster June made you out to be. You'll be exonerated as I promised. Even if my replacement questions the justification, overturning it would be more trouble than it's worth. I'm also sending a small reimbursement for your lost wages. It isn't much. There are more important things than pride and wealth. I hope you'll continue to use such good judgment in the future.
I'm a Mandalorian, Chancellor. We may not follow your rules, but we've got our priorities straight. You may not know how to handle a blaster, but you're prepared to die for what you believe in. That's good enough for me. Live in honor, Chancellor, wherever you end up.
This is the way to do it. Doing what we want when we want. Ain't nobody gonna say otherwise. Kinda glad I ain't killed you yet.
I'll take that as a compliment.
List of people I ain't gonna kill is real short. Figure I ain't going back to organized crime now that I got free run of the galaxy. But that don't mean I ain't got pull. Long as I'm running with you, you black son.
I'm not joining your gang, Skadge.
Wasn't asking. I was telling. All I'm saying is you and yours need something. Black Sun's got your back. Now quit making a fuss before I change my mind.
It's strange. I haven't always known you. It just doesn't seem possible. It's gotten hard to remember what life was like before we met.
I know what you mean.
I love you, you know. You probably guessed that already.
You don't have to tell me.
Yeah, but I feel slightly better for saying it out loud.
We've got to get back to work soon.
Mr. Romance strikes again. I suppose we should get back to work, huh?
Niska Takamu!
What's on your mind? You're glad that Dreely almost got you killed?
Yama Bisto Chanaga, Imecha, Tomicha! Hopo mawanka tuduska, udwana wada zuka kuba. Punta casa.